Welcome back to our third part of our shoulder series. The last two parts we have focused on stretching and mobilizing the shoulder and then also activating the rotator cuff muscles and the scapular stabilizers around the shoulder. This week our focus is going to be strengthening. I don't think we do enough accessory work in CrossFit. We spend a lot of times with our arms kind of locked in and a lot of like bilateral or symmetrical work, and we want to focus on it more unilateral work where we're having to stabilize that dumbbell or the kettlebell and keep it in one position because the barbell tends to lock us in place. We're going to have two parts to this video. The first part is going to be pre-workout where we're kind of priming the shoulder, getting it ready for the workout. And then the second part is going to be post-workout where we're focusing more of that accessory work I just kind of talked about.
Dr. Mimix, so she's going to start in a side plank. That side plank is how we're going to start our pre-workout activation. We're going to be holding 30 seconds. Notice how our hips are up high, right? Her hips are forward. This is the position that we're looking for here. She's actively pressing into that palm. Then she's going to hold that for 30 seconds, come down into our plank position. She's going to be doing a scap push-up. So scap push-up, she's only moving from the shoulder blades here. Imagine, right, that she's just trying to relax and then push against my hand. Good, but notice how her hips, very little movement in her hips, her arms stay straight. Okay, we don't want to think about this as a push-up. Now she's going to transition into, right, our side plank on the right side. Okay, same rules apply, okay? If this becomes too difficult, she can actually move this foot, yep, just right off to the side, right here, and if you want to make it a little more difficult, we can take this leg off the ground. Good, and hold, good, relax. So again, 30 seconds. Now from here, we're gonna actually go into some tempo-based push-ups. With that tempo base, or tempo push-up, we're gonna go 2 seconds down, nice and controlled, 1 second at that bottom, and press up. Okay, this is just a great primer for that press. Good, and relax. We're gonna shoot for about 8 to 10 reps. If you cannot maintain a good midline in this position, just go down to your knees or decrease the reps a little bit more. Or go onto a box or a bar, right? Plenty of scaling options, you know what to do, but maintain good position, good. Now from here, she's actually gonna come up onto this pillow bar. Okay, facing me, we're gonna go into supinated grip. Bar hangs, that supinated grip. Good. She can have her hands as wide or she can bring them in as narrow as she wants. Biggest thing to understand is that she's actively pulling down, right? I can see her neck, feet are together, nice solid midline. We're gonna hold that for 30 seconds, drop. Okay, and then we're gonna finish, right, with our kettlebell windmill. Okay, with that kettlebell windmill, grabbing it, okay? We're gonna have you turn and face just a little bit. Good, get your feet a little bit wider. Good, press the weight up. Good, now if the weight's on our right side, we're gonna have our toes pointing off to the left ever so slightly. Good, and she's gonna trace her left leg with her left hand as she looks up at that kettlebell. Good, standing up tall. Okay, again, reaching back to that right side with that hip. Good, one more. Okay, she keeps that kettlebell directly over that shoulder capsule. Good, nice and controlled, rest, okay? We're gonna have you go through this 2 rounds. I'm gonna have Emma grab that kettlebell, dumbbell, and she's gonna place one arm on. Good, and we're gonna bring ourselves, yeah, in this nice position here. And she's actually gonna row, and she's gonna row more up to like her hip. Yeah, good, and then back down. Good, again. Now with this one, if you do it just right, you're not gonna be able to move a lot of weight. That's the idea. The idea really is to hit more of the oblique in the lat as opposed to like bringing it up or shrugging it up to the shoulder, okay? Good, we can relax, okay? Both sides, you can rest a little bit in between each set. Now with this bottoms kettlebell press, okay? She's gonna be in a half kneeling position, okay? With that half kneeling position, good, we're gonna get that kettlebell up. Okay, so with this one, right, we're all about strengthening that shoulder girdle, right? So weight here, again, is not gonna be a priority. It's more about how much control you have over the movement. So she's gonna press up. Good, hold, 1, 2, then slowly come back down. Good, ready, press up. Good, 1, 2, come back down. Good, one more time. Good. Okay. okay? Control, that's what I wanna see here, okay? Try to shoot for about 2 to 3 sets. I have about 8 to 12 reps of each of these movements. Keep it very simple. If you have questions, ask your coach, but don't overcomplicate it, okay?